Hello, and welcome to another installment of TAMU HPRC's video tutorial series. My name is Shayna, and today I'll be showing you how to transfer files to, from, and between the TAMU HPRC supercomputing clusters using Globus Connect. It enables parallelized file transfers and is, on average, faster than rsync and much faster than SCP. Globus Connect, which I may refer to as just Globus throughout this video, is a file sharing and transfer system used by numerous academic institutions and organizations. Some of its capabilities include efficient large file transfer and file transfer recovery in case of an interruption. It can be used to transfer files between local and remote servers, academic institutions, and TAMU HPRC clusters via Globus Connect endpoints. Endpoints can be HPC clusters, servers, or a personal desktop. They can be configured through the Globus Connect interface. In this section, we will be performing a transfer between TAMU HPRC cluster endpoints. First, navigate to app.globus.org and select Texas A&M University from the drop-down menu. Typing Texas into the search box will help narrow the results down. Press Continue and log in using your university credentials. You may need to complete a two-factor authentication prompt. Click on File Manager in the left sidebar to open the file transfer interface. The default view will show one pane. You can adjust the number of panels on display using the collection of buttons in the top right. We'll go ahead and change it to the dual pane view. Click on Collection on either of the panes and enter TAMU in the search box to bring up a list of endpoints. The order in which you add each location does not matter because the connection will be bidirectional. In this case, we'll set up the left pane as Terra, TAMU, Terra-FTN, and the right pane as Grace, TAMU, Grace-DTN. The default location is your home directory, /home/netid, on both Terra and Grace. Most users store their data in their scratch directories, so you can simply put /scratch/user/netid in the box to update the directory on display. Select the files from the location you would like to transfer or sync files from, and then select Transfer or Sync To. The focus will shift to the destination endpoint, where you can select where you want to transfer or sync the source files to. You can also use the toolbar to create a new folder. Once having selected a destination, the Start button on the pane where you select the files to be transferred will activate. The transfer will be performed in the direction of the arrow on the Start button. In other words, a transfer activated using the button on the left panel will go from the location set in the left to the location set in the right panel. Before clicking it, you can adjust the transfer and sync options to label the transfer and perform other actions. Once verifying your transfer options, click the Start button and the transfer will begin. Alternatively, you can select files from the source location and drag and drop them into the pane of the location destination. You can track the status of transfers in activity in the left sidebar. You'll also receive an email notification when the transfer is complete. If a transfer is interrupted for any reason, Globus will resume it automatically. Additionally, if your credentials for connecting to the endpoints expire during a transfer, simply renewing them via the endpoint interface will resume the transfer. For convenience, you can also set bookmarks for commonly accessed locations by navigating to the folder through the File Manager and clicking the ribbon in the middle of the file transfer panes. When next selecting an endpoint, the bookmarks can act as shortcuts to specific directories. Now we'll cover transfers between a local machine, such as your computer, and a remote machine, such as Terra or Grace. While in the Globus Connect main interface, click on Endpoints in the left sidebar. Click Create a Personal Endpoint on the top right of the page. Download the appropriate Globus desktop client for your operating system. Once the download completes, start the installer to continue with setup. After installation, start the desktop client service by launching the application. Log in and authorize the application to access your files using your university credentials. Coming back to the browser, click on File Manager in the left sidebar to open the file transfer interface. Click on Collection on either of the panes to select endpoints for each. Select the files from the location you would like to transfer sync files from, then select Transfer or Sync To. The focus will shift to the destination endpoint, where you can select where you want to transfer or sync the source files to. Once having selected a destination, the Start button on the pane where you select the source files will activate. Click it, and the transfer will begin. Similar to the transfer between HPC endpoints, you can track the status of transfers in activity in the left sidebar. When you're finished using Globus Connect, you can log off by clicking on the second to last option on the left sidebar. Any file transfers in progress will continue even after logging off and closing the browser window. If conducting a transfer between your local machine's endpoint and a remote server, the Globus Connect desktop application must stay running on your local machine. Thank you for tuning into this installment. Please remember to like, favorite, and share this video, and subscribe to our channel for more content and tutorials. We'll see you in the next one.